I got the big one down below, let me tell you. I don't know why I keep doing that. I can't stop it. What's up, everybody? What's up, wrestling fans? It's Wednesday Night Dynamite. MJF has a big one down below where his little peepee goes. And there's a picture of him when he hadn't even... Well, there's a picture of him with CM Punk from when he was a kid. Hit that like button right now, guys. We need to make sure that the alert goes out to everybody. And the only way to do that now is to stick the thumb directly up the Rock's ass. There's only 31 likes. That makes me angry. I'm going to keep playing this loop music until this hits at least 100. I mean, let's go. Let's go. We'll do it again. CM Punk in the middle of the ring tonight. Delivering it, baby. 35 likes and counting. We must get to 100. Click the like button and stick the thumb up my ass all the way up my sphincter. Make my sphincter bleed when you hit the like button. Man, what a promo to start tonight. CM Punk in the middle of the ring. Looking like a full sex bot. Man, he looked good tonight. Well, at least the promo was good. I don't know why I'm bringing up what he looks like. It's kind of weird. He looked good, though, I guess. There's my phone alerting me that I was at my own front door like 5 hours ago. Good job, security system. That'll help. Only 5 hours too late. A little too late. Good job. And counting. Hit that like button, baby. CM Punk with a promo. Damn, he had a good line. I didn't even write the line down. I forgot to write the line down tonight, man. I don't remember exactly what it was, but I was like, damn, that was a fire promo, dude. Especially whatever he said at the end. What did he say at the end? It was great. It was really good. It was after he got MJF out there, but I don't know. It was good shit, man. Let's hear some of it. Let's hear a little bit of it.
Back on the toughest matches of my career. Matches where I've literally left pieces of myself in the ring.
All right, let's see what it was here. Let's see if we can hear it. CM Punk, we're looking for 100 likes, everybody.
I want you to take it all in, Max. And I want to leave you with this. This picture. You
naughty.
See it, Max? I'm sure you remember it well. Possibly the greatest day of your life, and to me, it was Friday.
It was Friday.
Sunday, March 6th, Orlando, Florida, Revolution pay-per-view is going to be the worst day of your life, and to me, it's just going to be Sunday. The price you paid to see me on this day pales in comparison to the price you will pay on March 6th. The canvas I sit on is not going to be stained with your shitty spray tan. It's going to be stained with your blood.
That was really good. The price you paid on this Friday to see me or whatever he said, that was, wow. That was good stuff. Let's go back. That was great stuff.
Sunday, March 6th, Orlando, Florida, Revolution pay-per-view is going to be the worst day of your life. And to me, it's just going to be Sunday. The price you paid to see me on this day pales in comparison to the price you will pay on March 6th.
Damn.
The canvas I sit on is not going to be stained with your shitty spray tan. It's going to be stained with your blood.
Well, that was better than any promo that happened on Monday Night Raw. You know, I mean, it was better than any promo that happened tonight on AEW as well. I mean, so let's just be honest, that was the best promo of the week or last 2 weeks or whatever you want to call it. So right there on the promo game, AEW wins again. So great stuff tonight. from CM Punk, obviously, as you know, you would expect from CM Punk. Simply been flawless, mostly. Looked good with the chain and the collar. I thought it was funny that they said, hey, the last time we had one of these matches, it was again, it was Cody Rhodes versus Brody Lee. I thought that was interesting. So what does this mean? Both of these guys are going away soon too? Because that's, I don't know, it was a very weird thing to say, but it's true. And they didn't care to go there. Oh, shit. Soundwave.
What if they filleted us?
Oh, my God. Soundwave's already donating. We haven't even. Shit.
And ate our children.
Oh, my God. What if the turkeys?
What if the turkeys ate us? What if they filleted us?
What's up, chat?
If the turkeys ate us.
Let's go.
If they had to hate us.
Fucking Thanksgiving was a little bit different.
Instead, the turkeys ate us.
They fucking gobbled us apart.
But first they'd eat our nuts. And then they'd eat our butt. The turkeys ate us. What if the turkeys ate us?
It's like a remix. I'm a fucking weirdo. I'm sorry. Anyway, Soundwave.
I enjoyed the hell out of the Punk promo.
Yes.
The whole first hour was fire. But like always, it kinda got rough towards the end of the second hour, and I enjoyed the main event till Andrade and his dumb fuck assistant interfered. Solid show, 7/10.
Yeah, I think I sort of thought that the fuckery was coming, and other people did too. So, you know, I was sort of prepared for that, I guess. I was fairly entertained by most things. I was actually entertained by the Thunder Rosa match. I really liked that. I saw some people didn't like it. I saw some people did like it. You know, Mercedes Martinez and Thunder Rosa, I had a fun time watching it. It wasn't the best thing. It was, you know, nothing was really done the greatest, you know. But I don't know why, but I had energy watching that match, you know what I mean? Dude, that Spanish fly, what the fuck, bro? That was retarded. Like, I mean, it was like a mangled car crash on purpose. Like, that was the most horrific, Spanish fly I've ever seen land, like, sort of correctly, but with impact that was incorrect. Right? It was like they landed, but like Sammy Guevara smashed down on him afterwards, like in an awkward way. I mean, dude, it was weird. It was not a smooth Spanish fly. Usually you see it looks all smooth and weird, like they just made love as they land together. This looked like a fucking bam, boom, like with him coming down on top of him. So, I mean, that was wild. Even Thunder Rosa and, you know, some of the, like, little tiny, like, not fully botches, but, like, the little mini, I would call them mini botches. There was a lot of mini botches tonight. Did anybody else notice that? There wasn't, like, a major botch or someone, whatever. There was just a little bit of a mini botch tonight in a lot of things. And when we saw those mini botches, it sort of made the match better because it felt like, oh, this is fun because it's not supposed to really happen this way or it feels different. Soundwave 92, man, thank you for the $29 and keeping my channel going, man. Thank you so much, bro. It means so much after a whole day that I went through today, man, to see a little dono plop right at the beginning of that of this show here tonight. I'm like, I know we're all tired. I'm sure a lot of you guys worked all day long as well. I'm just sort of getting used to being so busy again, so busy that I'm not used to it, man. I'm still not used to you know, being up at 6 a.m. And right now I'm going through some training, which on top of working and training, and then also, you know, so I'm just starting to learn to deal with not seeing my kids again. It's been weird. It's been kind of hard. Like, it's been, like, really hard being so busy. You know, so I really appreciate that, man. Thank you. So, I you know, I've been up since 6 a.m. I got six hours of sleep. And so one thing I'll say is I'm a little bit more awake than I was last night for Raw, or Monday night for Raw. So that's the good news, is this really, you know, this kept my interest so much more than Raw. I you know, it was a little bit, it wasn't the best tonight, especially since the first hour rocked, right? Like, that CM Punk opener happened and I was like, let's go. Like, let's go. Here we go. And I'm also feeling a little bit down about Cody. I'm going to be honest, man. I feel down about this Cody situation. He was important to me in AEW. Like, his matches were so different. He could have some of the best WWE style or classic style matches of anybody, you know? And the best thing about it was, it's the old WWE, though. The 90s WWE with some new stuff, you know? And he could have those classic 80s, 90s, and today all mixed into one matches as opposed to most other people. And I love that contrast of the idea that we get the Young Bucks, we get the Lucha Brothers, Kenny Omega has a match, Sammy Guevara does something, you know, CM Punk has his match, but then Cody has his match, and the mix of all these things, I really loved. I loved it. Adrenaline in my soul. Fucking love it. Love Cody. I don't even think me and Cody agree on a lot of things, right? Politically, fundamentally, we do, but there's a little bit of pompousness to him that a lot of people were starting to disconnect from him about. And, you know, he loves Star Trek. I love Star Trek. I mean, there's a lot of similarities, you know? And I think sometimes he was misunderstood, that he was trying to not necessarily virtue signal that he saved, like, race or whatever they say. Although I joke about him saying that, too, because even I feel like he comes across that way. I think he was just trying to say something positive, but it makes you seem more like a narcissistic elitist instead of anything. But I just like him, man. I think the absence without him is bad. I think this is not good for AEW. So I was a little bit down about that. If that's 100% that he's leaving and he's really going to WWE, it looks like he is. All the rumors point to The Rock showing up in WWE, Stone Cold Steve Austin showing up in WWE, and Cody Rhodes showing up for WrestleMania in some capacity. So that's huge. Yeah, man. I now work, and I know that I wasn't able to put up a video today, but I knew that we were going to be doing this tonight. So I figured, hey, like, not going to be able to get a video up because of how busy I am at work. Super busy season right now. And so I didn't put out a video today, but I would have liked to get one out about Cody and really going into that some more. So I'm going to be doing some more of that this week. I'm going to be potentially launching a new show. I believe it's going to be probably a half-hour podcast where I just, boom, rattle off the podcast and put up an hour on Patreon and a half an hour on YouTube for free. I don't know what I'm going to do yet, but that's coming potentially. So CM Punk crushes it at the beginning of this show on the mic with MJF. MJF just drops the mic, doesn't say anything. That's pretty fucking interesting. I thought that was well done. Well done stuff from MJF. Speaking of, you know, MJF, maybe he wasn't able to respond to The Rock because MJF was too busy having to respond to a 6-year-old girl today. So maybe that's why, you know, MJF, courtesy of Matthew Blasi on YouTube, maybe this is why MJF couldn't take on CM Punk.
How old are you?
Yeah. I'm 11.
Are you aware that your dad made a horrible mistake 11 years ago?
Your parents made it.
Oh, yeah? Mistake. Oh, yeah? What's your name? I don't give a shit. How's that? How's
breaking
that?
News,
your a Fozzie shirt? That's what we're going to wear in public? A Fozzie shirt.
And you wore that scarf in public.
What is that supposed to mean? It's a beautiful scarf. Anyone who thinks
$10.
Yeah? 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 If your dad had spent $10 for a condom, he'd be much happier. Trust me.
MJF saved it all for this little girl. All for this little girl. Condom jokes, sex jokes, dick jokes. I mean, you know, MJF talking about fucking to an 11-year-old. That's weird. I mean, cancel MJF, right? I'm just going to say it right now. It's weird.
All right, look in the stupid camera.
We're not done yet.
Jesus Christ, Dad.
What's your last name?
Wait, can I ask you?
That's you. That's you. Can. If you flip me off, I'm going to hit you in the face.
Do
tell
it.
Me right now.
I'm not scared.
I wish you can. Get a picture. All right, let's get our picture with him. Maybe we can burn it.
Thank you. Sorry about that.
We're just going to take off the recording.
Thanks.
Well, how beautiful is that? I mean, you know, I mean, how do you have anything left for CM Punk when you have to deal with a bitch like her? I mean, let's be honest, you got nothing left, right? I get it. I get it. Oh, here comes the donation. Oh, my God.
Great show, Joe. Take care.
Oh, great show. I mean, we just started. John Cream. John Cream coming in with the 21. Buenos noches. What's going on, everybody? If you approach MJF, you deserve what happens to you. I agree. It's fucking hilarious. Shout out to MJF, man. That's hilarious stuff. But he had none of that for CM Punk tonight. He had no retort for CM Punk. And by the way, I just want to shout out the top donators of this month, by the way. Here you are in this order. By the way, for the people that want to know, Sith Negan and Six are only off by $5. Sith Negan is in second place by $5. And Shell is in third, off by 256. Justin Gregory, the Soundwave 92, Santiago sends his regards, and the man, the OG, Tim Drake. Thank you, Tim Drake. Thanks to Junebug as well, Black Power, Colonel Santos, Colonel Stutters, and Six for becoming a $25 Patreon producer. Man, without you, we'd be dead. So thank you, sir, man, And I appreciate you guys bearing with me this week and next week as I have to go through training, plus work my shoot job, plus work for you guys here on wrestling. It is going to be a difficult week. It's been a difficult week since Monday and Sunday, actually. And it will be a difficult rest of the week and a difficult week next week as well. What makes it even more difficult is, unfortunately, my children have next week school vacation. And the things that I had planned to do, we are no longer able to do because I have to work a lot next week, so that sucks. And my kids will be home, so I'll be like teased having to listen to what I could be doing. So thank you for bearing with me for this week and next week, as potentially the content could be a little bit light. Thursday night, we're not going to do a straight-up beat the clock all night long like we have been doing. We're going to pause this Thursday so that this Friday, the Monetize This Championship is on the line. So the belt is on the line this Friday night. Monetize this. So be here on my channel by 11 o'clock p.m. Eastern time for Monetize This. The real Monetize This Championship is on the line. And then next week, Beat the Clock will be on Friday night. And then the following weeks after that, it should, I believe, return to Thursdays, hopefully. So there's a little programming note for all you people out there with AIDS. So thank you. Soundwave 92 with that 29 and John Cream. Like the initials of John Cream. But yeah, so opening is great. We haven't even got past this yet. But the bottom line is dog collar match. Here we go. CM Punk's ready. MJF drops the mic and takes off. He fucking punks him out with the pictures of him as a kid. All the stuff CM Punk said was wildly good. Great promo to start. Crowd's ready to go.
Wow.
MJF got nothing. And we move on from there on AEW. Great stuff. We even had Melissa Joan Hart. Friggin' Sabrina, the teenage witch, was there. I couldn't believe it. Man, I'll tell you what. There is something wildly hot about her, and there always have been. There always has been. You know? Can you imagine the freakish type of trailer park sex that you would have with her? You know what I mean? Can you imagine? By the way, we need to get rid of the tumor on the girl standing next to her. Good Lord, what is going on there? I mean, that's not a tit. I just want everybody to know that's not a tit. Just so you know, her tits are above that, or the girl behind her. So I don't know what's up. That girl is massive who's behind her. I mean, you know, there's the tits above. And then down below, there's like an alien. She's going to give birth to like a fucking tumor. You know, so I don't know what's really sure. Not 100% sure what that's about, but hey, listen, I don't judge. But Melissa Joan Hart, man, looking like a fucking trailer park whore, which I love. I think she looks pretty, to be honest. She used to follow me on Twitter, and I used to think that was cool, but then I realized she followed like 200,000 people, and I realized it was just a bot thing for her. So... But yeah, Melissa Joan Hart, not sure why she's there. Probably because she lives there, I suppose. But fucking man, she's my type of fucking hoochie. Let me tell you that. La, 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 la. Oh man, I'd love to just tear it up, you know? And then speaking of tearing it up, Daniel Bryan gets in the ring and has a phenomenal match against Brandon Lee, like the crow. What? I don't know. Time to get a new name. Lee Moriarty, there it is. Yeah, Lee Moriarty, there we go. I knew the chat would help eventually, see? Would I use a hall pass on Melissa Joan Hart? I mean, that's fucking terrible. I mean, like, here's why I would use the hall pass on Melissa Joan Hart, only because it's attainable, right? Like, most people have the hall pass or whatever you call it. That would never happen, right? It's always that's not going to happen. That would never happen. So, like, that's why you do it. But I would use it on Melissa Joan Hart because I think I could actually get... I think I could find that hall. I think I could get there. You know what I'm saying? I think I could get there. So, for that reason, yeah, maybe I would. Maybe I would because I think it could happen. And I bet you she'd be like, oh, like, I don't know. Like, I don't even know what would happen. I'm being a sicko. I mean, I would rather use it on somebody like younger or someone, you know, like, it's hard to say because there's like, everybody's too old now. You know what I mean? Like, it's not really like I would want to use it on Shirley Manson. Right. But do I really want to use it on Shirley Manson now? You know what I mean? It's like my wife, like Leah. My wife might want to use her hall pass on... Well, actually, see, she's lucky. She likes a bunch of guys right now who are in their prime. And I don't like a bunch of girls who are in their prime. I can't name many. Can you guys name women that I think... Because I don't know any younger women that I like. Like, in their 30s and 20s. I can't think of them. I think I like the one girl from Game of Thrones. The fucking elf chick. Or the wildling chick. You know, that girl? I like her. She's married to the fucking what's-his-face. You know what I mean? But Shirley Manson is too... She's so old now. I mean, like, I... Even when I look at Shirley Manson now, I go, huh. Like, she's starting to look a little grandma-like. You know what I mean? But she's still pretty to me, but it's like, but it's weird now. But I don't know, man. Like, it almost would be like hooking up with a different person. You know, it's not quite the girl that I, you know, the woman that I used to like, you know. She's a little bit more like an older woman, you know. Like, I used to be attracted to the younger Shirley Manson, you know. But if I was married to Shirley from, like, 30 years old, you know, I'm sure I'd love her and still be attracted to her. Because I'm, like look at Shirley Manson and Bono here. Look at Shirley, bro. Dude, that's the girl that I was, when I was a kid, I was like, oh, my God, bro, I'm going to die. I'm going to die, bro. Even in 2005, Shirley Manson. Even 2005, Shirley Manson. You know what I mean? Even 2005, 40-year-old Shirley Manson. In 2005, right? Was she 40 here? 40-something? She's 40-something years old here. Even 40-something in 2005. I was 21. Would have been perfect right then to meet her. Still was like, yeah, that's it, man. There she is. But now, you know, now it's like Shirley Manson is very, very much older. You know what I mean? She doesn't quite look that same way at all. You know what I mean? She looks like a lot more like a grandmother. You know what I mean? Like, but she's still pretty, though. That's the thing is I would still hook up with Shirley Manson. Like, she's like 60 or something now. But I would still hook up with her. She's still pretty. But I mean, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I wouldn't hook up with anybody because I like my wife. But I'm just saying the hall pass thing. You know, Shirley's starting to look like a kind of like a grandma. You know? But it's not that long ago that she didn't, right? I feel like it was just the other day. It was 1998 and she looked like... Dude, you realize in 1998, Shirley was like 30-something years old? You know? It's 30 years later. She's now 60-something. But at 30 years old, she looked amazing. I mean, dude, that's 30 years old right here. That's 30. Can you imagine what she looked like when she was 20? She probably didn't look done yet. You know what I mean? Like, what does Shirley Manson look like when she was 20? She probably looked like she wasn't finished. She probably looked 12 when she was 20. This is her at 30. She's 30 years old there. 1999 or something. This is 30 years old. Oh, my God. I mean, dude, this is like 50 right here. And this is like no makeup. I mean, bro. So anyway, how do we get off on this tangent about what the fuck are we talking about? We're supposed to be talking about AEW. What is going on right now? So that would have been my pick, but now it's... And so anyway, what I was trying to compare this to is I think Leah's in some ways... Well, I know Leah likes the Viking people like Travis Fimmel and those type of guys. So she has plenty to pick from that are younger. But before that, one of her things was she liked Harrison Ford. Leah really liked Harrison Ford. And I know Leah likes Eminem too, right? But dude, have you seen Eminem? Eminem looks fucked. You know what I mean? Eminem reminds me of Shirley Manson. Look, like I think Eminem is Leah's Shirley Manson. Because Eminem used to look like crazy. Like, he used to look way different. In fact, I would say that Eminem is Leah's Shirley Manson. Because there's Eminem in his prime age of like 20-something, right? He's like 20 here, right? This is like totally why Leah liked me. She was like, you look like Eminem, and I like that. You know what I mean? I never found, you know, so like this is why she liked Eminem. But now the dude looks like Tom Green traveling around the world in his van. You know what I mean? He has to like put the beard that he can barely grow over his face so he can hide this weird face that he now has. Like, he looks like he's got a much older face now. Like, he's going to look like... See, and he's like 40-something, right? Or 50? So imagine what he's going to... He's going to look like Shirley Manson when he's 60. He's going to have that old guy face like Shirley Manson. And the thing about these people is the reason is because they looked so young for so long. Like, they had great genes for so long. But then when you get old, it's like, boom, overnight. You're like, fuck, you looked pretty good And now you look like a grandpa overnight. That's what it's like, because it's almost like you skipped your 40s. You know, you stayed 20 and 30, and then you skipped your 40s, and then even your 50s, and then boom, 60. It's just, wow, like, what happened? So that's what I think is going to happen to Eminem. So there you go. So, you know, but I think she also liked Harrison Ford, and Harrison Ford is the same way. Leah sees Harrison Ford now, and she's like, oh, man, he looks like an old grandpa man, you know? So it's like, you don't get that same feeling of like, oh, fuck yeah, look at that person. Like, look at Shirley Manson, man. Look at her. Oh, my God. Even when she was 40, oh, my God, you know? But, you know, and that's what I think even women thought about Harrison Ford, because Harrison Ford, you know, was 40 when he looked good in his movies, just like Shirley Manson looked good at 40. But, it took Harrison Ford turning fucking 80 to finally look kind of, you know, like, yeah, that's that guy's, you know, that looks like an old guy, you know? I don't know. You know, he's starting, like, he looks like a really good old man, right? Like, Harrison Ford looks like a really good old-looking guy. Like, he is a very good old-looking person. But he's at the point where he's so old-looking that you can't imagine fornicating with this man, you know, at this point. Because you'd be like, hey, hi, go ahead. It's just weird. Same thing with Shirley Manson. Like, oh, yeah. Ooh. Like, it's like, it's weird, man. I don't know. Like, you can't, it's like gotten beyond the point now. Where, you know, 50 was okay even, but like 70 and this look, it's like, yeah, he looks nice, and that's still Harrison Ford, and he's a good-looking old man, but he's got that old guy vibe that's different now. You know that, you know what I mean? Like, so there you go. What the fuck are we talking about? Anyway, back to wrestling. I blame this on whoever. Bro, what up, a psycho knee kick? Oh, my God! Guys, I got to be honest, dude. I didn't see that live. I was eating food, and I was watching, I thought, everything. Holy shit. Daniel Bryan hit him with the Bisaiku knee kick. And by the way, I'm so glad that they finally call it that again. Remember in WWE for years when I would say, like, why don't they call it the Bisaiku knee kick? Or why don't they call it at least, like, the Daniel Bryan kick or the mega kick or something different, you know? But they called it nothing. They never had a name for his finisher ever. And it was like, why? Why the fuck? That's like one of the most awesome things. Why don't they call that something? The yes kick, the yes down, or some name. They never came up with one. And it drove me nuts for years. I always brought this up on my old reviews in WWE. Why is Daniel Bryan do the kick? And it's almost like they don't even acknowledge it. I don't get that. That was always a huge mistake to me. They never called it the kick, the super mega kick, or the drop bomb kick, or make up something, or the running knee. They called it like a running knee or something like that. I don't know. But it was like, dude, come up with a real name or a real fucking call. Like, go listen. They barely ever call it anything. They just sort of say it like a regular move. Like, oh, he slammed him. It's weird.
Danielson, he changed his expression to one of very unsettling in my eyes.
But this is a great one here, man. He catches him. I didn't see this. Let's see it now. Here it comes.
Psycho knee.
Done. I guess they just called it the running knee. You know what I mean? I guess that's what it is. You know? But anyway, I don't know why you guys wanted to talk about what women look like. I blame it on you. I think it was the Melissa Joan Hart comments.
Danielson, he's just waved off.
So Bryan Danielson, and Lee Moriarty, man, they fucking killed it. They were getting the crowd going on some mat wrestling, some old type of shit, technical stuff, Chris Benoit, Dean Malenko type of shit. I mean, they were really, really taking over this audience here at the beginning. It was beautiful to see. CM Punk set it up with a beautiful promo that wasn't too long. It was like a 10-minute segment. 10 minutes of CM Punk and MJF. Boom, boom, boom. On to the match that was really good. It really it ended with, you know, kind of Daniel Bryan asserting the dominance and just destroying and whatever. Fine. You know, I understand. So it was a little bit of a whatever. But the match, it was entertaining to see. It was very entertaining to see, and I was happy to see it. So great job there by Daniel Bryan and Lee Moriarty starting this thing off beautifully, getting the crowd going. And then once it was over, out comes John Moxley. And he was definitely hammered. No, I'm just kidding. And he comes to the ring. Some weird fan with a leopard skin phone screaming next to him. 7 foot tall, weird looking guy, probably touches dogs. You know, but we're not going to hold that against him. You know, it's okay. You do what you want with your life, you know. And, you know, he comes to the ring, cut a little promo with Bryan Danielson. I'm not going to really get into that too much. And then we finally hear from Keith Lee.
Of the Revolution ladder match, and it's so fitting. As the first person to qualify, this is the one instance where you don't save the best for last. It is the first and best and the new face of the Revolution. It is yours truly, the Limitless One, Keith Lee. And when I tell you I'm coming here to make a statement, phase one is done. The ladder match is phase two, and when I'm done with that, the TNT Championship shall be mine.
And with that calm demeanor delivery from Keith Lee, it comes off better than almost anything had in WWE. Because in WWE, Keith Lee spoke a little too weird, you know? In WWE, Keith Lee spoke a little too like, I am Keith Lee. I am in the middle of the ring. It was very weird. Very weird. Here he's just more like a man saying what he's going to do. I mean, this came off more like a guy, the regular guy that we'd all know and love and whatever, things like that. So great job.
He's a big monster with a great...
So there you go. And then JR goes racist and calls him a monster, which is just racist. If you describe a person like that in any other way but person, you know, you're going to be racist. A lot of people saying he's racist for calling him a monster. You know, called him a bear cat. That would have been racist too. Not the best rap from Max Caster. You know, he's had some really good raps recently. We've really enjoyed the raps from Max Caster. He's destroyed on the mic quite a bit. We've enjoyed it. Tonight, it was pretty good, but it was nothing crazy. You know, no Lori Light, no Chicago murder rate. No eyes are going to bug out like Lori Lightfoot. You know, nothing really too crazy. Pretty tame here, but good and clever and nice for the moment. But nothing that was like, oh, shit.
He can beat me, he crazy. Acclaim beating brothers down more than the baby. Look at him, I'm not tripping. He's overrated like Nashville hot chicken. I'm not the guy to be fighting. I knock you out first round like the Titans. And we all know the sitch, boy. You're not a man, just MJF's bitch boy.
I love these guys. I absolutely love the Acclaimed, man. I mean, listen, they don't do much in the ring, and certainly the one that enjoys men is really boring, but I love them both together. I love them. This thing is fucking bizarre. I don't understand why they scissor. I still don't know. If somebody can find out why they do this, and they do this weird scissor thing, I don't get it. I mean... like, what is that? I don't get it. Like, you're lesbians and scissoring? Why? Like, shouldn't you guys be doing this? One of the guys in the tag team is gay. So shouldn't you guys be doing this? Like, oh, like, shouldn't you do that? I mean, or like, I don't get it. I guess I'm trying to figure that out. I love it. Either way, I don't care. I think it's fucking hilarious. In fact, I think it would be even funnier if it was both. Like, you do, oh, or he was doing this, ah, or like... or they just did, like, or they just, I don't even know. Or they did this, like, like just to piss people off who, like, don't like gay people. Just irritate people and be like, yeah, you don't like that. I think it'd be funny. I'd do that. And someone would be like, oh, you're not, what are you, gay too? No, man, I just, fuck it. I like pissing off the people that don't like it. It's funny. Fucking got a problem with my fucking shit. Fuck you. I love the Acclaimed. I like both of them. Good stuff. Best thing since Enzo and Cass, since the New Age Outlaws. And this promo was probably a 6 out of 10 rap for them. You know, they can do better, but, you know, it was, what are they going to do? You know, they always got to come out. It's always Wardlow. What are you going to say? I mean, you know, what are you going to say about Tennessee that, or Nashville? You know, I mean, what are you going to say about fucking, what are you going to say about Tennessee that already hasn't been said about a demilitarized zone? You know what I mean? So, I mean, they just come out there and they cut the best promo they can, and it's fun. So enjoyed that. Up till this point, I mean, the show is a, I believe the show is an 8 out of 10 at this point, okay? 8 out of 10 at this point. This match happens. It's blah-de-de-blah. It's more of the same. You know, I give it sort of like a 6 out of 10. So that drops the show to about a 7.8, 7.6 or something like that. The Britt Baker thing, and suddenly the karate guy from Cobra Kai is here, which is weird, and he's like, you're going to have to kill them. And it's just like, I get it. I love Cobra Kai. I love the Karate Kid. Love that he was there, you know? But I like it, kind of. It was a little weird, sort of, like, for someone to come in and get in Britt Baker's thing and be playing. It was very WWE, I felt. Thought it was all right, though. It's kind of weird. Again, like, sort of a 6 out of 10 situation in that promo. And then, you know, Cowboy Shit comes out there, says some things. They kick out Tony. I really wasn't feeling the Adam Cole. I got to be honest, I wasn't feeling it. I almost don't care. I'm sorry. Am I in the minority here? I didn't care that much about Adam Cole and Adam Page. I think Adam Page is very bad right now. I think this world title is dead right now for some reason. I don't, even though Adam Page had this crazy match a few weeks back, I don't know, man. I don't connect with this guy at all. I can't connect with him. I don't feel it. I don't feel nothing. I feel like he reminds me of like when Dean Ambrose was WWE champion or something. I mean, very weird, man. This is a problem. I feel like Adam Cole, I just didn't care that much. Maybe people cared. I'm at a loss, kind of. I'm worried.
For the first time in history, it's going to start raining men. It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Amen. I'm going to go out. I'm going to let myself get absolutely soaking wet. It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Every specimen in town.
Soundwave 92.
I love how nobody brought up the Cody shit and instead gave us a black ref for Black History Month.
Well, oh wait. I love how nobody brought up the Cody shit and instead gave us a black ref for Black History Month. Oh my God. That is hilarious. They did say the Cody Rhodes was in the first ever dog collar match with Brody Lee. So they did say Brody Lee and Cody Rhodes were in the first ever dog collar match. And I guess that didn't work out for them too well. But now CM Punk and MJF will be in one. Hopefully they won't be leaving too. But, you know, so that was interesting. They did bring him up there, but they, you know, didn't bring up many other things. You know? So, that's interesting, man. But thank you so much, Soundwave. You are the top dog with $29. And we're going to hear what you guys are saying on the donations, man. We're going to hear what you guys are saying. We're about halfway through Dynamite right now as far as me talking about it. We've made it halfway through. There's another hour to talk about still, but, you know, less to talk about in the second hour, to be honest. So we're getting close here to the end of everything to say about it. But let's hear from the donators first, and then we'll go back to talking about it.
You donated $50. I'm going to take my dick out because you donated $50.
Oh,
you
shit.
You donated $50, motherfucker boy. I'm a rich motherfucker.
Good show tonight. 710 says Soundwave said beginning is always the best. Still better than anything Raw can produce. Shout out to the chat, and my personal pervert Mr. Pico LOL hashtag Tex Cult.
Wow, Tex Cult. A lot of people are trying to get Tex to win the Monetize This Championship this Friday night. Anybody could win. Who knows where the belt could go? What could happen? What if it goes to some psychotic person? I don't know. Shell, thank you. $50 bomb! They mentioned Cody three times. Hangman is more interesting than watching tribal shit. I don't know what that means. But Shell, thank you for the $50. Damn. Well, I think Shell just... Well, she's not. She didn't take the lead yet, but Shell, thank you. Wow, holy shit. Holy shit, Shell.
Super chat wow. Party!
Thank you, Shell. Here comes Alex Oli getting in line.
Cody left his, so I'm sure MJF will do the same 2024.
Wow. Can you imagine if MJF goes to WWE? I mean, what's the point, though? He can't talk. So what if MJF goes to WWE? What, then he can't really talk. So it's like, well, that's a waste of everything, you know? Great, MJF goes to WWE and now is basically a shell of himself? God, I hope that don't happen. You know, you really want that to happen? Unless he's able to speak, why would you want that to happen? No way you'd want that to happen. That's bad, bad news. There's a lot of shows coming out, man, that I might be able to do reviews for, John. I know you mentioned it before, but yeah, we might be able to do. There's, you know, Halo's coming out, fucking Star Trek's coming out. It's a whole bunch of shit coming out. So there's a lot of good stuff coming. We'll see what happens. Let's see. He'll go for the money. I mean, oh, man. I mean, yeah, I mean, he might go for the money. That's true, but, man, I will. I mean, we'll be the losers. We'll be the ones losing. Shell, thank you so much. Alex Oli, thank you. Super chat's coming in now.
Super chat party!
Oh, Roman Reigns, Andy. Yeah. I get it now, Andy. Thank you.
I'd sop up Shell's snatch gravy with some cornbread.
Ooh. You know, I don't know if I'd recommend that, man. I got to be honest, Mr. Pico, that might be a little weird, I got to say. Thank you for the dono, though. The $2 coming in from Mr. Pico Boulevard. I don't know, man. I'm going to need all your help to win that Monetize This Championship. This Friday night on Monetize This, after SmackDown and AEW, me versus everybody. And people are trying to say Tex is going to beat me for the Monetize This Championship. We can't let that happen. Can't let that happen. Oh, my God. Magpul Mike.
Hey, Joe, would use a hall pass on Jade Cargill or Brandi Rhodes?
Oh, man, maybe Brandi. I like Jade, but Jade is more like somebody I'd want to, like, break me in half and, like, treat me like a bitch. You know what I mean? Like, I've never had that done to me. I'm not really that type of person. But I would totally be like the slave. I would if it was Jade. I would let that happen. But Magpul Mike, it's great to hear from you, man. You're a classic OG, man. Thank you. But yeah, Brandi would be. She's so beautiful. Like, yeah. I don't know. I wouldn't do a hall pass though. Probably.
Super chat party.
My wife will tell you she would do one of those Viking people.
WrestleCon need to on commentary for Suzuki versus Busick.
We need, me on commentary. Suzuki versus Biff Busick? Is that what you're saying? That'd be great. Alex Oli, thank you. That'd be awesome. I don't think any wrestling companies are calling me, though. You know? I've tried, I've pretty much given up that dream, you know? I've given up the dream. That will be my biggest regret in my life. That it just won't happen. Oh my God, he's here!
My name is Kane and I'm donating a house.
Joe, your show is awesome. Adam Cole sucks.
Oh. You know, it's like I like Adam Cole, but I don't 100% get it. It's his excitement that I like usually, but I find Adam Cole more exciting usually than, Adam Hangman Page has been boring to me. I feel like Adam Page would be better if he was kind of like how Shawn Michaels was as a bad guy. I feel like Adam Page reminds me of HBK when he was a good guy. You know, after the boyhood dream came true, that's who Adam Page kind of reminds me of right now. A little bit on a smaller scale, but you know, it's kind of like the boyhood dream came true. He's just a good guy. Johnny Bravo, thank you, man. Bravo. Bravo to Bravo. What's up? Oh man, yeah, I don't know. I get that vibe from him though, that goody guy, but I don't really, you know, but when Shawn Michaels was like, "I'm the heartbreak kid," like that sort of thing, I like that much better. When he had the bravado and the nastiness. Give me that Shawn Michaels. Give me that guy. But Adam Page is more like, you know, I came out here and I said I was going to do some cowboy shit. Yeah! And I did that cowboy shit. And the fact of the matter is, I had to bust my ass to get back here in front of all you guys. And I told you that I'd retain this championship and that I would be a champion one day. And that's what I did. I love this business. I love this ring. And I love that I kind of sound like Bill Clinton right now a bit. When Joe does, I don't even know who this is that I'm doing right now, but whatever. And I hit you with that clothesline and I cracked your damn skull. And now I am the AEW champion. And quite frankly, this promo is boring as hell. I don't get it. I mean, that's what he sounds like to me. You know? Shawn Michaels, you know, could come out and be like, "Quite frankly, I told you the heartbreak kid was going to become," you know, and it was like, wow, like it was some feeling behind it, you know? But Adam Hangman Page was just like, I knew from the first swig of beer that I had from one of the fans in the front row that I was going to be AEW champion. And that I was going to hoist this AEW title up above my head in front of all you people. And I'd hear you cheer and I'd feel that energy. And we would win this together as I hit the buckshot lariat on his ass. Wow. He's just boring. Boring. But damn, I don't sound like Hank Hill. The fact of the matter is, damn it, I became AEW champion. Imagine if I went out there and just started doing Hank Hill. Like, but didn't ever reference it. Just, that's my voice. They're like, "Welcome to Joe Cronin. He's the new announcer. Joe Cronin, come here. What's it feel like to be hired by AEW?
But I'll tell you what, damn it, the first thing I said when I was back there was I said, hey, it's going to be a hell of a thing. Boy, I can't wait to call the action. What a clothesline off the rope."
And then JR's like, are you doing Hank Hill?
What's a hill? What's a Hank of a hill? All I did was call the damn wrestling." He's like,
"You sound just like the guy from King of the Hill. You don't know, in Beavis and Butthead, you never seen that?
What the hell are you talking about?" You know?
And just like, till it drives JR nuts. I don't know.
"Boy, I tell you, Bobby, I'd love to butt pump Lady Bird."
I should be a voice actor. I am a voice actor. It's just a matter of, are you going to hire me? It's a matter of if you can hire me. I'm not really a good voice actor, I don't think. I'm not a good guy that does impressions. I'm not good at I mean, I do a couple little things like, it's me, Jake Roberts, you know. It's me, the big guy, Ryback. I got this chicken sandwich. Like, I can do those, like, little goofy twists on people. Like, it's Stone Cold Steve Austin. I told Vince McMahon I didn't give a damn. Like those little things like, well, you know, I'm the best there is, the best there was, and the best there was ever in Calgary, Alberta. The Hitman, you know, I can do those little gyrations of people, but I'm not really good, and I'm not that great at it. But I always wanted to be a voice actor, like in video games. I always wanted to be a wrestling commentator, and, you know, it just comes down to, will people hire me? And I don't know. Who's going to hire me? I mean, I don't know. Nobody. I've applied to many things. I've gotten a few things, you know, just not a lot. You know, nothing to make whatever. Yeah, I think that's, I'd be, you know, I've done voice acting. You know, it's a matter of hiring me. I never really did Peter Griffin. I tried one time, a couple times I tried Peter Griffin. I didn't watch a lot of Family Guy, but I think he sounds like, he's Rhode Island, right? Like Massachusetts, Rhode Island. Like, and he's like got the, you know, Hey, Lois, why don't you bend me over and put a dildo in my asshole, Lois? Hey, Lois, get the dog out of me. Hey, Lois, the dog is trying to fuck my asshole. Oh, my God, Lois, what the fuck? Like, it's something like that. I don't know. I've only seen probably 20, 25 episodes of Family Guy in the background and shit like that. Ow. I used to be able to kind of do the fat child, too, the fat kid in the show. Mom says that it was something like that. I don't know. I can't really do it anymore. But it was something like that. I used to be able to do him too. I'm not really good with voices. I would be more like the host of the show who brings on people who do voices. I only do them out of necessity. I don't have anybody on my show who can do voices anymore, you know? I used to have people that could do them, you know? I would look for people that could do voices because I didn't want to do them and I couldn't do them all the time. And now my voice suffers because of it. You know, Jesse can do a goddamn good Hannibal, though, I'll tell you that. Remember when Vince McMahon called The Undertaker? Well, Mark, I want to tell you, I think I really, I want you to come back at WrestleMania. I need you to lose to the, I need you to come back at WrestleMania. I need you to lose to The Undertaker. I mean, I need you to lose to Brock Lesnar. Vince, did you just say that you wanted me to lose at WrestleMania to Brock Lesnar? Yeah, it's basically what I'm trying to ask you, Mark, is you lose the streak to Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania. Me and Pat Patterson talked about it after I butt pumped him. And Mark, I think it's gonna be good for business. I gotta be honest. You're crazy, Vince McMahon. You're out of your mind. I don't know why, but on the phone, Undertaker Mark Calloway talks just like Undertaker for some reason over the phone. Maybe Hangman could use a manager. Yeah, maybe. What does he need? Jose Nathario, like fucking Shawn Michaels. I mean, he really reminds me of a Shawn Michaels face promo. You know, from what, 1995? 96? I think it was 96. Let's hear it.
Shawn Michaels, San Antonio, publicly humiliated. Boy, wouldn't that be a first. The only thing is, the heartbreaking Shawn Michaels has been humiliated a number of times. So you're going to have to do...
So I want you to look at this right now, because this right here is Shawn Michaels as a baby face, which he was not a baby face very often. This was baby face Shawn Michaels when he was the WWE champion, or when he was about to be, or sometime around then. This is why he reminds me of Hangman Page.
Boy, wouldn't that be a first? The only thing is,
The heartbreak kid Shawn Michaels has been humiliated a number of times.
The heartbreak kid Shawn Michaels, he couldn't even say his name.
So you're going to have to do a little bit better than that. But when you're talking about 71,000 screaming South Texas people, yeah, it's my backyard, but it's also the backyard of Jose Lothario, my friend. And Sid, he is a legend in South Texas. And believe me, they don't like what you've done to him. Sid, you and I have an understanding. You beat me for the World Wrestling Federation Championship, and you know I don't cry over spilt milk. The problem you and I have is what you do with Jose. And in the meantime, I'm going to take back what is right.
You see what I'm talking about? He lost all of his muster, all of his luster as a face. The old Shawn Michaels, even a few years before this, would say, the heartbreak kid Shawn Michaels doesn't need you. I don't need nobody because I go out there, baby, and all the women look at me and blah, 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 and I'm better than most of you fat, disgusting people. The heartbreak kid Shawn Michaels did what he had to do for the Intercontinental title. Like, I'm going to do this, that, and the other thing. And he kind of sounded a little bit more brash. And, like, you were like, oh, okay, he's a cunt. I like it. You know, but this good guy version of that is not very good. And then he gets better, though. Then he gets better later. I mean, like, that's 1996. I mean, dude, 1996. Let's go to 1997. Just 1 year later. Just 1 year later. 1 year later. And we get this.
When the World Wrestling Federation begged and pleaded that I be a guest referee, so what did I do? I did that, and I did one hell of a job.
Much better when he becomes a heel here. And then he gets better and better when he becomes more of a dick. Then he becomes even better. Then DX is on fire. And now he's talking about, the fact of the matter is, the heartbreak kid, Shawn Michaels, could take every single woman in this arena home and show her one of the most amazing nights, because I have one of the most amazing sticks you've ever seen. And I'm the champ, baby. Shawn Michaels, D-Generation X. Like, and it was like, wow, like, he was like, well, that's way better than, like, that face thing. So that old Shawn Michaels, face Shawn Michaels, when he finally became a face after being a heel for 7 years or 5 years, that face Shawn Michaels that was boring then turned into a great heel Shawn Michaels. That face Shawn Michaels, though, is what Hangman Page reminds me of right now.
Well, you know, it's all about doing cowboy shit.
The only thing is, he says shit. He does say shit, and he does bleed a little bit, you know.
But really, it's all about doing that cowboy shit.
But what Adam Page needs to do, Adam Page needs to realize that the title doesn't make the man makes the title. And the title had been made, but now that it's gotten to Adam Hangman Page, the title is starting to be unmade. And he may not believe that. He may not like that. He may not agree with me, but it's what's happening. That title is becoming devalued. And I don't know what to say. And listen, Adam Hangman Page, you're having great matches, bro. You're having good pretty good matches. Okay? Is this on? Is this on? Is this on? Is this on? But Adam, bro, you're going to have to grab a mic. You're going to have to grab a mic, Adam Hangman Page, and you're going to have to do this. Give me a picture of Adam Hangman Page. All right, let's hear what he said tonight. Let's go back and listen, because I like to do this, because sometimes I'm wrong, and sometimes I forget, and sometimes I get, you know, detracted or whatever. Let's hear what he said for a second.
Where you been, Andy? I would be proud of. So trust me when I tell you, son. Here, I'm here in AEW. And truth be told, now that I'm here in AEW, or any time we've been in the same promotion together, you've always just been known as the other Adam. respect and admiration championship and you.
I got to be honest, this don't look good. Like, this don't look good. When I see this, Adam Cole comes off to me like the master here. Adam Page looks like a side guy, like a guy on the sidelines, having to watch Daddy, you know, cut a promo here. This is not good to me. We're in trouble.
If I could share the ring with anybody here in AEW, it would be you. That's what I think about you. So trust me when I tell you, someday we're...
The sucking up is weird.
What a world...
It's a death match for the AEW...
Adam Page. First of all, Nashville, if you could do me a favor...
Yeah, unfortunately, Adam just comes off like the guy that, like, he just, man, he doesn't, this was a bad decision. Adam Page had a bad promo last couple of times, not very good promos, and this, he comes off like a kid who shouldn't have the belt, and he was never given a chance to retort this the right way. This is a huge mistake. I think this makes Adam Cole look great, and it makes Adam Page look real bad. This is not good. Not good.
On a roommate, standing in the ring with the AEW World Champion, looking at this belt and knowing it's the only world championship you will never hold.
He'll never hold the WWE title. He'll never hold these other titles too, right? So he never held them. Why did he say that?
Hangman, your Bullet Club buddy with your Ring of Honor roommate, standing in the ring with the AEW World Champion.
Man, he just doesn't seem right. He doesn't seem right. Like, I don't know what it is, bro.
Standing in the ring with the AEW Champion, I had a beer before I came out here. You know, maybe I'll have another beer. I might just have another beer. Do you want a beer? I might just have another beer. Hey, I'm just happy to be here. How does it feel to look at the only title you'll never have?
Wow, you got me. You got me, Adam.
Oh, how does it feel to have the belt you'll never have?
Well, I'm here, you're here, and eventually we're going to be in a match together. And that comment is going to sound really, really stupid, Adam. Adam Hangman Page. And see, this is the reason why you are called the other Adam. Because after I do beat you for that championship, you never have it again, ever. Nobody will bear. The only thing you'll be remembered for is the guy who lost so that Adam Cole could become the AEW World Champion. You'll never have the belt again. All right? Mr. Buckshot Lariat, fake cowboy guy. You're barely a champion. You certainly aren't a cowboy. I'm going to legitimize that belt. That belt is going to legitimize me, unlike with you and that belt, who appear to be a couple of just incompatible elements standing in the ring, pretending to be something that they're not, all because you've had, three successful title defenses or two? How many have you had now? What, you held onto the belt two or three times now? How long have you been champion? Adam, let's not play games, bro. Let's not play games. I can see how scared you are. I literally can see how scared. Look at him. He don't look right. He looks scared. Stand up straight. Look down, Adam Cole.
Looking at this belt and knowing it's the only world championship.
Looking at this belt and knowing it's the only world championship.
Championship you will never hold.
You will never hold. You will never hold.
Wow, you got him.
Hangman, that's funny that you bring up friendship. That's really, really ironic. Because let's talk about friendship for a minute. Let's talk about Nick and Matt Jackson, the Young Bucks. Because I haven't heard them say your name in weeks now. Or even better, how about the Dark Order? I mean, that's supposed to be your crew, right? You haven't been associated with them for months. So truth be told, what kind of friend are you?
I mean, I don't know. I guess I don't get it.
I'm not perfect. Really, when I think about it, I don't know that you have the best record with friendship either, do you? So sure, yeah, I have some regrets. And I've made some mistakes. And the more you talk, the more I'm thinking that getting into the ring with me tonight might be one of your biggest.
Hey, come on. Okay, listen, Hangman, I'm just being frank with you, okay? Because I've known you for over 10 years. I've known you for over a decade. And you've become an unbelievable professional wrestler. And an unbelievable world champion. But now, Hangman, I'm here in AEW. And truth be told, now that I'm here in AEW, or any time we've been in the same promotion together, you've always just been known as the other Adam.
Just missing Eve now.
Yeah. Hey, wait, stop, Hangman, seriously, stop. Listen to me, okay? Seriously, look me in the eyes. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. I have nothing but love, respect, and admiration for you. If I could share the ring with anybody here in AEW, it would be you. That's what I think about you. So trust me when I tell you, someday we are going to fight for that AEW World Championship. And when we do, it'll be man to man, me and you, for that very title. And when that day does come, filled with respect, may the best man win.
Very uncharacteristic gesture there by Adam Cole, but as he mentioned, these men have a lot of history with one another.
Yeah, so let the speculation begin.
I wasn't sure what you said. That smile on his face.
It's Adam Cole, baby.
Smug, self-satisfied Adam Cole. Hangman Adam Page. What?
Wait a minute.
Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish, Red Dragon. Adam Cole's friends assaulting Hangman from behind.
Is anyone surprised at this?
And look at this.
3-on-1.
So the champion comes off looking kind of like a moron. Now, I get it. It's the face spot. You know, he's like, hey, let's, you know. But they got to do something to make Adam Page, I mean, Hangman, look cooler. You know? You know, Adam Page could have said things like, you know, well, Adam Cole, baby, you know, I am the AEW World Champion. And I am the AEW World Champion because I'm that good. You see, I don't need to jump to another promotion because my wife is there so she can cuddle me. I don't need to cry on Twitch to all my fans. Oh, I love you. Thank you guys for, you don't know what you've done for me. Oh, my supporters. Oh, I got to go cuddle with my wife in AEW. Oh, I got to become friends with a bunch of dudes that I stabbed in the back a little while ago. You know, that's what you surround yourself with people. Maybe that's why I don't need anybody around me. Listen, I got no problem with the Dark Order. I love those guys. And yeah, maybe I haven't always been there, but I'm me and I can get things done on my own. You can't, Adam. That's your problem. To this day, that's always been your problem. You've always needed a crew, a group, whatever, a girl to give you a hug to make all the boo-boos better. But cowboy shit is about going out and getting jobs done, getting shit done on your own with nothing but a beer in one hand, a title in another, these people cheering for you. And a buckshot lariat to the back of some sorry son of a bitch's head. And the fact of the matter is, Adam Cole, Adam Page are standing in the ring together right now. And there's no reason why we couldn't get it on right now in front of these people. And I can show everybody here why you just simply suck without a crew of clowns. Hey, listen, Adam, you know, listen, you're the champion. Someday we are going to wrestle, you know what I mean? But, you know, we don't have to do it now. Someday it will happen. And when it does, listen, man, I'm sorry. I was just trying to talk some sense into you, you know? But, hey, when that day arrives, man, may the best man win. Handshake. All right. May the best man win when it happens, man. You know it will, right? All right. Blah, blah, blah. I'm out of here. Oh, they jumped in from behind. He offered a match. And what the hell kind of cowards attack? You know, but instead, Adam Page is just like,
I don't know with the Dark Order, but I'm... Yeah, I don't know.
Like, it was just like, what the fuck, bro? Why does your world champion look like shit? Why does your world champion look like shit? Sound like shit? Oh. I just think you could have gone into those things. And you could make things a little bit better. I mean, granted, whatever. I just think he reminds me of the good. And I love Shawn Michaels. He's like my favorite wrestler of all time. And when I was 12 years old, I was rooting for Shawn to beat Bret at WrestleMania 12. But after that, Shawn, you know, he did get like the good guy that maybe the kids liked, and that was it. Hey, man. I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to show everybody why the Heartbreak Kid, why Shawn Michaels and Jose Lothario. And it was just like, it was nice, but it was like boring, you know? You know, Hogan didn't bore me, even though he had boring face type of stuff. Even the Warrior didn't bore you because he was so nuts. Stone Cold never bored you. HBK as a heel never bored me. And then later on in life as a face didn't. Bret the Hitman Hart, you know, was kind of boring until he became a heel. And told you about where the damn hose would be put in Pittsburgh. That was great. Adam Cole has an eating disorder, people are saying. Really? You think so?
Looks like my little lass needs a shaving.
Oh, no.
Pico here. Paige having worst title reign since the Mountie had IC belt. He dresses like every kid who got picture taken at Kmart in the 70s. Cody's going to win Andre Battle Royal at Mania by eliminating No Way Jose. Shell, you ever play hide?
You ever play hide the bratwurst? Tex, how is your syphilis? Says Mr. Pico Boulevard. Thank you. He really does? It's weird. Brother Ultimate Warrior sounded like he was on crack. I know.
The fact of the matter is, you are cooking when I can tell you to do.
That's what the Warrior sounded like. Bring it on any day, man.
Well, you know something, dude. I'm going to walk down to the ring, and if Sid Justice wants to get involved, dude, I might have a big leg drop for him, brother, right in front of all my Hulkamaniacs. And what you going to do, Sid, when Hulkamania runs wild all over you, dude?
But see, that was still more entertaining than, well, I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to do what I do best, and that's cowboy shit in front of all my fans. You know, it's like you could debate on which one of those is better. But see, I would say, you know, I would just go out there as the champion. Can I open up the night as, you know, on the mic real quick? Can I have 3 minutes? Got a promo tonight. What's up, everybody? I'm going to keep it real short. Your champion is here to tell you one quick thing and to tell somebody back there in the locker room that tonight I feel like fighting in Houston. Who wants to see Adam Hangman Page do some cowboy shit tonight on Dynamite? That's exactly what I hoped you'd say. So tonight, Tony Khan, I don't care who it is, I want to put this belt on the line. And I want to show Houston what cowboy shit looks like. Who's got a beer for Adam Hangman Page? Who's got the beer? You know, Adam jumps out of the ring. He goes into the crowd. He grabs a beer. He holds it up. And then he fucking, yeah! Fucking holds the belt up. There ain't a soul on this earth that's taking this title from your champ, baby. Woo! We're going to fucking commercial. People are freaking out. That's it. 3 minutes. 2 minutes. Actually, you know what you could really do? Is, you know, just have a match right after that. Just do shit like that. Have a fucking pulse. Act like you still have something to prove, even though you're the champion. But instead, what Adam Page is kind of like, just like, yeah, I'm the champion. Hey, man, I'm the champion. And I told you I would be. And hey, man, if you got a problem with me, why don't we do it right now? Why don't we do it right now? Fucking boring, bro. Let's go! You know what also would have been awesome? If he just slapped Adam Cole. If he just, boom, slapped him and then started fighting him and then he got jumped from behind. That would have been okay too. But, you know, unfortunately, Adam Page comes off like a bitch. Looks pretty good in matches. Looks pretty legit in matches, but on the promo is a disappointing person. And that's all I got to say about that. Jericho's tag match, you know, decent little tag match. The Inner Circle is in inner turmoil. I didn't care too much for it. Didn't care about the Young Bucks. Cobra Kai was out there. I got super excited when I saw Thunder Rosa, as we talked about earlier. Great stuff, Thunder Rosa. Thunder Rosa and Mercedes Martinez had a sloppy, uneven, hardcore type of match that entertained me. I thought it was entertaining. I liked it. 7 out of 10 hardcore match. 6.8 out of 10 hardcore match. Entertaining enough for me. Mercedes Martinez loses. Britt Baker is told to kill her, you know, by Cobra Kai, bad guy. I thought that was funny. But also kind of weird. Looks like Buddy Murphy is coming to AEW. Why? Why is Buddy Murphy coming to AEW? What is Buddy Murphy going to do? Be the new Pac? Oh, look, another short, muscly guy who flips everywhere. Yeah, whatever. I don't care. So Buddy Murphy's coming, but who gives a shit? Jay White looks like a crackhead off the street that I wouldn't pay to beat somebody up that I didn't like. You know? Look, another skinny guy with a black jacket that looks like Adam Cole, I guess. So, whatever. None of this is good. Then Darby Allin and Sting come out. Sammy Guevara and Darby Allin have a pretty good match and saves the second hour a bit from being kind of a failure. I would say the first hour is a thumbs up, obviously. Second hour was on its way to a thumbs down. Thunder Rosa and Mercedes Martinez turned it up a little bit to a thumbs. Ooh! And then Darby Allin and Sammy Guevara made that thumb go, thumbs up, barely. So, you know, I would give AEW tonight probably a 7 out of 10, maybe a 6.5 out of 10, but I'll go 7 because the first hour was so good or so decent. So 7 out of 10 show tonight for me. That's what I thought. And a lot of you guys have been saying the same tonight as well. So that's understandable. Jay White is a crackhead Seth Rollins. God damn. Arn Anderson better be doing his own thing since Cody is being a dingle. Well, they took away all of Cody Rhodes' power, I guess, in AEW. And they weren't letting him book anything. And that was his whole thing, was he wanted to book stuff, I guess. I don't know. Who knows the real story? Maybe we'll see the real story at some point. I don't know. But unlike when people go to AEW, they're free to do all these interviews everywhere. So when people leave WWE, they get to do these interviews everywhere, exposing everything that they felt about WWE. But now, leaving AEW, is Cody Rhodes going to get the chance to expose everything about AEW everywhere? I don't know. I think the thing to do would be to go on Jericho's podcast. You know what I mean? But maybe he doesn't get along with you. Oh, my God! Whoa!
Dynamite tonight. I give a 6.5 out of 10. Good show, but nothing special. Rumor is now that Cody may sign back to WWE this weekend, probably. Also, Joe, can you, when you have time, go to my channel and vote on the community tab, my latest poll?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is the OG of JCS himself, one of the all-time top donators ever, J.D. Venom. J.D. Venom, holy shit, dude. He's always been such a big supporter, man. J.D., I will go. I'm not sub to you.
10 things that...
Why am I not sub to you? J.D., bro, it is so good to hear from you again, man. Thank you so much, man. I didn't know you were doing all this stuff on your channel. Why wasn't I sub to you? Let me go over to your community tab. What the hell is going on? How can I vote on this when I don't know 100%? How do you want to watch my GM from creators? Regular 10 to 20 minutes or live streams? I think I usually prefer these in 10 to 20 minute videos. But I would say once a week or once every couple weeks do a live event where you do it live. So I think you should mostly do the 10, 20 minute videos. But then I think every week or 2 weeks you should do a live stream. Go check out JD Venom's videos, man. He's got almost 6,000 subs at this point. He's never promoted his stuff on my channel almost ever.
Super chat party!
Other people seem to want you to do the live thing, though.
Thunder Rosa Parks sits in back of the Lex Express.
Oh, no. Mr. Pico Boulevard. Oh, my God, Mr. Pico Boulevard. But it looks like most of your listeners are saying to do it live, though. So people want you to do it live. So maybe do it live. Fuck it, do it live. Why haven't I... Hello? What are you doing? What are you doing? Is that the cat? Doing. Jesus Christ, the cats are fucking kicking the shit out of each other. They were chasing each other. I didn't know the cats are down here. They're stuck in the basement. The door is closed. The two cats are in the basement fucking tearing shit up out there. I'm like, there's either a kid awake throwing things or like, what's going on out there? It was the cats fucking chasing each other. Let me see.
WWE 2K22's GM mode looks amazing, guys. Hey, what's up, guys? JD Venom here, back with you here on the channel. Do all the YouTube stuff here before we begin here today. Let's not waste any more time. Let's break down what we saw here today. There was a trailer that came out a few hours before the...
Damn, JD Venom, you're fucking killing it on these videos.
WCW, wherever you like, right? Now, I'm not too sure you can change the brands themselves, right? But you can at least download the cause.
Bro, you should hit me up. We should talk a little bit about the game at some point. You know, do like a little stream or a little podcast where you can kind of tell me about the game and stuff like that. That'd be kind of cool because you know a lot more about what's going on with it than me. That'd be pretty cool, man. This looks great.
Why there's not online playing for this? Which can affect answered. One of my biggest things was auto-generated calls. And we are going to get some... I won't say they're auto-generated. It looks like they're in the game already. But they are generated calls. man, oh man, we're gonna get, you know, a whole bunch of different type of calls, and which is pretty awesome to me, right?
Yeah, man, I like these. I like the way you edit the videos too, and you separate them all. That's pretty cool.
Before the Attitude Era, before the coming to the ring here, and you know, I will never ever doubt anything again on what I saw in the
dude, Natural Butch Reed. That's hilarious.
Dynamite Kid, the
the 1988 WWE. That's pretty cool shit. That's on the 2K20 sim. Yeah, man. I gotta look at more of your videos. But yeah, man, I would I think your people want you to do it live. But I mean, I would do 10 to 20 minutes and then also do live. GM mode's fun. People always want me to play that. But you know, hey, what are you gonna do? But that being said, I'm gonna call it a night. Only because you know how busy I am this week. I should tap out and get out of here, I suppose. Because, oh my God, Melissa Joan Hart taking pictures with the Young Bucks. Oh my God. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Let's go.
Hey, baby. What's up, baby? What'd you say ahead of me?
Oh, you're going to rub up on me? You won't let me pet you, but you're going to rub up on me? What a whore you are. Fucking cat. Yeah, man, Melissa, look at that, man. Lick her up. Think she's a fan of the Young Bucks. I used to remember when she used to follow me, and I was like, oh, cool, Melissa Joan Hart follows me. Remember that I said that earlier? And then I was like, oh, she follows everybody. What I mean by that is her Twitter bot follows 1,000 people every day. And when her Twitter bot follows 1,000 people every day, like 700 of those people follow her back because they're regular people, mostly people with only 50 followers or 400 followers. And they go, oh my God, Melissa Joan Hart followed me. What the fuck? And then they're like, I don't follow her though. Or like, who's this blue check mark? Oh, yeah. What are they doing following me? It must have been something I said, maybe. I don't know. And then they follow her back and then they grow their audience. See? She follows 160,000 people. Why would a celebrity follow 160,000 people? And most celebrities who are legit on here only follow between like 5 people to maybe 5 to 10,000 or less. You know, mostly it's a couple thousand at the most. But even if they follow a lot, it's like 10,000 or less. But for her to follow 160,000, it's because a bot is doing it. So she really doesn't have, like, you know what I mean? So I was excited, like, oh, wow, what the hell's going on? And then I'm like, oh, she just has a bot doing it, you know? But she had some fun tonight at AEW with a friend. Apparently that girl that was behind her is her friend, maybe. Oops, shouldn't have made fun of her. I would totally get, I would love, you know, if Leah allowed me to, I would definitely go out with these two women. Have a good time. Let them just crush me. So that'd be pretty cool. See. Apparently she had a fun time tonight, you know? See, on Instagram, she doesn't have a bot because on Instagram, you can't really have a bot doing this. Because it doesn't work on Instagram, you get fucked over if you do it on Instagram. So take a look at her Instagram. She has 1.7 million followers on Instagram, yet she's only following 2,000 people. See? Why is she following 160,000 on Twitter, but only 2,000 on Instagram? It's because the Instagram's more legit, and the Twitter is fake, mostly. But she does have a lot of followers, though. So, I mean, I don't know why you need a bot. You're already famous. You know, I don't know. Dude, Clarissa explains it all. I wanted to fucking explain it all onto her. You know? Back in the day. This is a weird photo of her. I'd like to see her in like a movie where she like plays like a main role of somebody and she's so not herself. Like, I want to see Melissa Joan Hart on an episode of Law and Order where she is like a rapist. She like worked at the Boys and Girls Club and raped boys. And the special victims unit comes to arrest her at the end and she's like, I don't care. I love touching all of them. You know, that'd be great. Like, to see her in a different role where she's not wholesome and funny and giggly. It's like, no, man. She's in an episode of Law and Order where she, like, literally was, like, a rapist. Like, can we get Melissa Joan Hart in that sort of role? Please? Like, tomorrow? Please? Like, right now? Let's go. Get on this. Look at her, look how she looks. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for being here tonight, AEW. I give it, like I said, A. Chris Hansen, what's up? Thank you. We're going to need you to go ahead and arrest Melissa Joan Hart in the episode of Law & Order, Chris Hansen. Thank you for being here. What's up, Kevin? So I think that'd be a role for her, to be honest. Law & Order Special Victims Unit. Melissa Joan Hart plays a psycho rapist. Be a wonderful idea. JD Venom, thanks so much, man. Go give his channel some love. Thanks to everybody who donated tonight. Thanks to Shell for being the top donator. Tomorrow night, Thursday night, while we might not necessarily be doing Beat the Clock, we will be, I believe, doing a stream. A hangout with everybody the same way we normally would do Beat the Clock, maybe, but just not late. And then Friday night, we will be late as the Monetize This Championship is on the line Friday night. Come on down for that. Let's get weird. Let's do a butt funnel. I have a super duper early morning tomorrow. Super duper early morning tomorrow. Wish me luck. I wish all of you luck. Thank you. 6 or 7 out of 10 AEW. You know, 6.5. It's hard for me to say. We're going to have a fun time tomorrow and Friday night. And then the weekend, there's going to be a lot of wrestling news to catch up on. I'm going to be doing a big podcast about wrestling because we really got to catch up on some of these news stories. I got to talk about some of this. This is just too weird. What's going on? Fucking crazy. Yeah, the Celtics, what are they doing, man? They're on steroids now. Tim Dillon puts out a great tweet. The government is banning people on social media, freezing their bank accounts, getting their friends in the media to dox them, and convincing everyone this is good for society. Oh, that it's for the good of society. I mean, there's some weird shit going on. Nobody cares, though. Nobody cares. Everybody thinks you're a conspiracy theorist or something. The government is freezing people's bank accounts. Like, that's happening. I mean, this is how everything dies. very weird. And we're running out of every material we have. Can't even sell shit anymore. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now ready to go. Night night. Thank you, Shell.
Good night.
It was a big, huge sausage fest. I had to hop in.
Enzo looking shredded. Adam Cole looks like a bitch. Wow. Damn. Enzo looking like Adam Rose. Remember when Adam Rose got ripped after he got fired? Good God. Wow. Bold. Enzo Amore.